blueprint has been discovered. On our second day here, Chris Kuma told us about the motive, which was a bounty hunt. Jamilian and Justine came up with an idea to play a simple game of catch, locking us into separate locations until the time limit passed. Justine offered to stay with Jama, Jadiego, and Joss, the three that me, Jamilian, and Question Mark hadn't yet met. While everything was being gathered and prepared for our room, someone was already making moves. Jamilian. He broke the light switch of the shack and left it on, as well as dropped various tools all around the backyard. As a last touch, Jamilian filled a nearby bucket with water, all to create an opportunity for someone else to start the killing. When it turned 12 o'clock, everyone gathered to the room and we played catch, not expecting the trap that was already laid out. Eventually, Jamilian hit the switch with the tennis ball and caused the lights to go out, while also breaking the switch in the process. Apparently, Jafin was his target all along, probably since the description of the bounty fit the ultimate number 2 well.
Jafin!
Using the fear he learned about to his advantage, he made Jafin rush out of the room as the soon-to-be culprit followed behind her. Supposedly, the other group found out about the light switch around the same time as ours, creating the illusion the lights were tainted with at the same time. Once Jafin rushed outside, probably to get some fresh air, she got hit on the head by a tennis ball, creating a bump on the back of her head. This was all done so Jamilian could distract Jafin, creating a free opportunity for the culprit. Of course, nothing could have happened and that would be it, but seeing everything laid out in front of them probably convinced the culprit to go for it. So they grabbed the crowd scraper, since it was the quickest tool to use, and went for it. The culprit positioned himself in a way that made the blood splatter away from them and probably guided the body down to the position we found it in. The culprit then proceeded to use the bucket to clean the weapon and the little amount of blood that probably got on them. After the cleaning, they met up with Justine and stayed silent, knowing we'd be on their trail soon. They probably believed that Jafin was indeed the bounty and didn't need to clean up too much, as they believed they would get away with this. But Chris Kuma's silence spoke loud, and it was only a matter of time before we caught them. We still don't know your real name, but you've referred to yourself as Question Mark, the ultimate scrawler. Oh, God. Time to see some blood splatter. I couldn't have said it better myself. Now then, everyone, please look to the screen on your side. And also, make double sure you vote for the right person. I wouldn't want to do anything drastic. Well, I would actually really like to do that, so if maybe one of you could—
Yeah, we got it. No need to say stupid stuff.
Alrighty! Everyone, please vote!
This sucks.
Going strong, yo, going strong, yo. Get down on the ground, we're going strong, yo. Going strong, yo, going strong, yo. Show the what's up now and leave with a pow. Going, going, going strong, eh. Going, going, going strong, eh. Going, going, going strong, eh. Going,